मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मॉड्यूल नंबर 3, दैट इज परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ लॉन्ग ट्रांसमिशन लाइन्स यूजिंग रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ लॉन्ग लाइन बाय इक्विवेलेंट टी मॉडल। सो इक्विवेलेंट टी सेक्शन मॉडल हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस। सो रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ लॉन्ग ट्रांसमिशन लाइन बाय इक्विवेलेंट टी मॉडल, सो this is nothing but the circuit diagram what we are seeing here. This circuit diagram exactly looks like T section model of an medium transmission line, because long transmission lines are those transmission lines usually the transmission line length is greater than 150 kilometers and the operating voltage is greater than 100 kilovolts. So instead of the parameters what we are taken into account, like in T section model for medium transmission lines, I am taken that first half of the segment as Z/2, second half of the segment as another Z/2, and the capacitance admittance as Y. But to overcome the difficulty of the parameters which we are taken as a reference for medium transmission line T section model and long transmission line T section model, here I consider Z as capital Z dash and Y dash in this network. The remaining same parameters what we discussed in your earlier video for nominal T section model for a medium transmission line. If you go through this given network here, Vs is called as sending end voltage and Vr is called as the receiving end voltage. Sending end current here it is Is, receiving end current here it is Ir. The total transmission line here it is divided into two half intervals. During first half interval or first segment, the total line resistance is divided as R/2 and the total inductive reactance is divided as X/2 for one segment. So R/2 plus X/2, here we can consider it as Z/2 for the first segment. Similarly, for the second segment, again R is R/2 and again X as X/2. The sum of R/2 plus X/2 here I can written as Z/2. So these are the assumptions which we are taken into account for better understand about the concept of long line transmission line by an equivalent T model network. Now the representation of long lines by T equivalent is shown in this figure. The generalized equation for the T network from the medium transmission line, from the concept of medium transmission line, we already discussed about that. The equations which are derived for medium transmission line, that is Vs bar is equal Vr bar of 1 plus Yz/2 plus Ir bar of Z into 1 plus Zy/4. So that is equation number 1. And next one, Is bar is equal Vr bar of Y plus Ir bar of 1 plus Zy/2 as equation number 2. The above two equations I am going to make as for representation of T section network for long transmission lines. I am going to replace the parameters like Z and Y with Z dash and Y dash. Wherever here we have the Y and Z parameters, I am going to replace it as Y dash and Z dash. Therefore, the above equations 1 and 2, I rewritten as a equation number 3 and 4. Now here, the above equations, that is Z is replaced as Z dash and Y is replaced as Y dash. Therefore, the sending end voltage and receiving end, sending end voltage equation and sending end current equation follows as like this. That is Vs bar is equal Vr bar of 1 plus Y dash bar into Z dash bar divided by 2 plus Ir bar into Z dash bar of 1 plus Z dash bar into Y dash bar by 4, represented as equation number 3 from equation number 1. Similarly, Is bar is equal Vr bar into Y dash bar plus Ir bar of 1 plus Z dash bar Y dash bar divided by 2 as equation number 4. Now that equation number 3 and 4, I am going to compare with the general equations of ABCD parameters or transmission parameters like equation number 5 and 6. Equation number 5 and equation number 6, that is Vs bar is equal AVR bar plus BIR bar, Is bar is equal CVR bar plus DIR bar. So here sending end voltage and sending end current, that is input port voltage and input port currents, represented as output port voltage and output port currents in the two equations. So therefore these equations are called as general equations of the ABCD parameters or the transmission parameters. By comparing that equation number 5 and 6 with equation number 3 and 4. Here, A bar is equal 1 plus Y dash bar into Z dash bar divided by 2. Similarly, B bar is equal Z dash bar of 1 plus Z dash bar into Y dash bar divided by 4. Similarly, C dash bar is equal Y dash bar. Similarly, D dash bar is equal 1 plus Z dash bar into Y dash bar divided by 2. So, from these two equations, from these four equations of A, B, C, D, what we compared from the above equation number 3 and 4 and 5 and 6, here we notice that A bar equation is also equal to D bar equation. That is, A bar is equal 1 plus Y bar Z bar dash divided by 2. That is equal D bar also. Therefore, from this comparison, I am going to take in that again, that is, whatever here we written that transmission parameters equation, I am going to represent that transmission parameters equation in the form of an hyperbolic trigonometry equations. Why I am writing that hyperbolic trigonometry equations means hyperbolic trigonometry is used to solve that variation of line inductive reactance and line capacitive reactance according to hyperbola curve. Therefore, for a two-port network or for a given transmission line, the sending end side voltage and sending end side current is written as hyperbolic trigonometry general equations like Vs bar is equal Vr bar of cos h gamma l plus Ir bar of Zc sin h gamma l. Similarly, Is bar is equal Vr bar divided by Zc into sin h gamma l plus Ir bar of cos h gamma l. Next. So, now I am going to compare the coefficients of cos h gamma l, sin h gamma l. That means the coefficients of Vr bar, Ir bar, here again Vr bar, here again Ir bar. That means these two equations I am going to compare with equations number 3 and 4. Therefore, I am going to equate here. Here I am equated that Zc into sin h gamma l. This is this equation. Zc into sin h gamma l from here. I can write that Z dash bar of 1 plus Z dash bar into Y dash bar divided by 4. So, from here, I can, one more thing I can compare here, that is 1 by Zc of sin h gamma l here, 1 by Zc of sin h gamma l, that is equal Y bar from the equation number 3 and 4, that is here. Similarly, I can compare that one more comparison, that is cos h gamma l, cos h gamma l, that is Vr bar coefficient, that is from cos h gamma l, I am going to compare with equation number 3 and 4, here I got cos h gamma l is equal 1 plus Z dash bar into Y dash bar divided by 2. So, if I am going to compare all these above two equations with above equation number 3 and 4, here I got all these comparison equations. Now, I am going to take in that to determine the shunt branch of equivalent T circuit, consider the above equation. That is, Y dash bar is equal from here, this equation. From this equation, again I rewritten here, Y dash bar is equal 1 by Zc sin h gamma l. From here, Y dash bar is equal to 1 by Zc. Zc means we know that formula from surge impedance loading. Zc is equal to square root of Z by Y. I am going to substitute Zc is equal to square root of Z by Y. This is nothing but the basic formula what we know from the concept of transmission lines from the hyperbolic trigonometry. I am substituted in the place of Zc. So, 1 by Zc here. In the place of denominator, I am substituted square root of Z by Y. It become as square root of Y by Z. Again, after doing simplification. Now, in this equation, I am going to multiply and divide with square root of YZ into L for the above equation. If I am going to multiply and divide for the above equation, then Y dash bar is equal to square root of Y by Z into square root of YZ into L divided by square root of YZ into L. Then here this root Z denominator, here root Z numerator get cancelled. This root Y here, root Z denominator root Z cancel. Numerator root Y, here numerator root Y into root Y here. It turns into Y here. Y, then remaining L is there. we can written as yl into sin h gamma l divided by this denominator function root of yz into l, we will write it as it is at here. Next. In next step, I rewritten the equation. Therefore, y dash is equal yl sin h gamma l divided by denominator. Here I got gamma l. Gamma l means square root of yz is equal to gamma. So if square root of yz is equal to gamma as a constant, I can take it into count. Then here the formula can become as gamma l in the denominator. Next. Therefore, y dash is equal to y into sin h gamma l divided by gamma l, and here I can write that sin h gamma l divided by zc, because zc is nothing but square root of zy. So here gamma l plus I can write as like this. Next. Similarly, from the above equation, 1 plus z dash into y dash divided by 2, that is equal to cos h gamma l from the above equation. Now substitute the above equation, that is y dash, that is equal y into sin h gamma l divided by gamma l. In the above equation we get, that is here y dash is there in the place of y dash. I am going to substitute this equation, then I got this equation. So now after doing simplification here, we got z dash by 2 sin h gamma l divided by zc sin h gamma l minus 1. How I got minus 1 here? Here left hand side 1 I am sending to the right hand side. Here I got minus 1 at right hand side. Now again I am going to write that z dash by 2, that is sin h gamma l, means we can write that 2 sin h gamma l by 2 into cos h gamma l by 2 divided by zc, that is equal here cos h gamma l minus 1, means we can write that cos h square gamma l by 2 plus sin h square gamma l by 2 minus cos h square gamma l by 2 plus sin h square gamma l by 2. In these two equations, in this equation here, we notice that minus cos h square gamma l by 2 plus cos h square gamma l by 2 get cancelled. Remaining sin h square gamma l by 2 sin h square gamma l by 2, here we got sin h square gamma l by 2 plus sin h square gamma l by 2, here 2 sin h square gamma l by 2 at right hand side. Again after doing simplification, here we got z dash by 2, left hand side z dash by 2 is equal, here zc come as same, and 2 sin h gamma l by 2, here whatever in the numerator function is there, here it will come to denominator function. If it will come like that, then remaining equation z dash by 2 is equal zc into 2 sin h square gamma l by 2, 2 sin h gamma l by 2 into cos h gamma l by 2. So here z dash by 2 is equal to zc into the overall function, can written as the overall function 2 sin h gamma, 2 sin h square gamma l by 2 divided by 2 sin h gamma l by 2 into cos h gamma l by 2, we can written as tan h gamma l by 2. So z dash by 2 is equal to zc into tan h gamma l by 2 again. So from here zc means we know that square root of z by square root of z by y. I can substitute in the place of zc, again z dash by 2 can become as root of z y into tan h gamma l by 2. So again after doing simplification, this equation z dash by 2 is equal to, so multiply and divide square root of y into z l by 2 in the above equation again. So if I am going to multiply and divide again, square root of yz into l by 2, here this function I got. So in this equation again, this root y denominator, here numerator root y get cancelled, here root z, root z becomes z. So already denominator 2 is there, here we got 2 z by 2, and again l is there, we got z by 2 into l. Denominator is square root of yz l by 2 into tan h gamma l by 2. So again here z dash by 2 is equal z l by 2 into tan h gamma l divided by square root of yz l into by 2. Here it can written as gamma l. If it is written as gamma l, the above simplified equation can become as z dash by 2 is equal z l by 2 into tan h gamma l by 2 divided by gamma l by 2. This means in order to get that series branch of the equivalent T section network, the series branch of the nominal T section can be considered as a lumped series impedance. It should be multiplied by the factor of tan h gamma l by 2 divided by gamma l by 2. Thereby here we can find out that variation of reactance and line resistance as to regulate the voltage. Thank you.